Hey everybody, HMAC here, and today we're doing a quick startup guide for modded Valheim. Mods unlock a whole new world, and if you're like me and waiting for the Hearth and Home update, you're probably looking for something fresh and exciting. Well, gentlemen, and the five ladies that watch my content. Oh, and I really do mean the five of you. But I love you all equally and want anyone to feel welcome to my channel. But yes, ladies and gentlemen, if you want more frequent updates than what the Valheim devs are able to give us currently, let me tell you a little bit about getting started using mods, along with some really important tips for starting out in this new world and gaining gold quickly. Now, the first thing you need to do is just scroll right down, click the like button, and subscribe with notifications. Oh, I bet you thought you were out of the intro. Sorry about that. Had to throw it in there. But now, let's get into the video. In all seriousness.
HMAC, they know you're not a serious guy.
Okay, man. I've wasted enough of their time. Just hold off for now. The first thing you'll need to get started in modded Valheim is a mod manager. I'm taking you through the process of getting started on Blackwatch Nation, but you can also do this for your own server. After joining the Discord, submitting a ticket, and getting whitelisted, you're going to click this link and start download of R2 ModMan. While we're here, let's just download these other files. You'll need them anyway. Now we will just run R2 ModMan and select Valheim as our game. Let's create a new profile and import the files.
One of the files we downloaded before?
Yeah, man. Select the .r2z. That contains all of the mods for the server. So once it loads the profile, you should see 35 mods installed. I have more because they're admin mods, but you're not allowed to have those different mods when you load in. Once we've loaded that, we'll need to get into settings and select Browse Profile Folder. You'll want to pull up downloads and locate everything previously installed because we'll need to add them. After everything is unzipped, we'll take the BepInX folder from the first, drag and drop, and drag and drop it into the profile folder. You'll replace the files and then repeat this for the hotfix. We may ask you to do this again so we can adjust the configs as easily as possible, so come back to the section if you need a reminder. After we've updated the BepInX file, we'll go back to R2 and start modded. This will bring us to Valheim Plus start screen, and we select our new character. Hit start, join IP, and the server IP should already be filled in. If it's not, you can find it in the rules section on Discord. After a short time, you'll see an auto-filled password, hit enter, and you're off and running.
Wow, that's easier than I thought. But still, I mean, they could make it easier, right?
Yeah, one thing we are all hoping for is mod support from the developers. But for now, this is a pretty good method and just a little bit more work. Okay, now we've got everything squared away, we've started a new character with a fresh haircut.
And with Mac in the name.
Yup, throw Mac in your name if you would like to join the cool kids table. So now we're dropped in like any other server, but our goal is to quickly and efficiently dominate this place. In order to do that, you'll need some gold.
How much? We should probably save up for Mergengerberg Gamble Belt so we can carry more gold, right?
However you say it, no, the trader is much more than a belt and worm dealer on this server. One big difference from vanilla play is that you'll be able to gain great loot and gold much faster. And the main method of actually acquiring that gold is by selling items to the trader and completing quests. We've set the trader up to have a ton of gold and an endless need for random junk, so really nothing goes to waste. There are a lot of different things you can farm to get your wallet fat, but my favorite are mob spawners. The easiest one to start out with would probably be Grayling spawners, but burial chambers can also be a great place to start. With all of the loot and items these creatures will drop, you can just sit here and destroy everything that pops out. Like most community servers, it's frowned upon to destroy these spawners because they won't respawn, and more than one person will probably end up watching this video, so I'd like everybody to be able to do this. Grayling spawners and skellies are fine, and they should be easy to manage, even very early on your run. But once you get enough good loot, you should really look to farm draugrs. They'll drop higher value items, and through testing, you can get enough loot to earn about 800 gold per minute. That means that just by farming one draugr spawner, you'll be able to purchase a 40k pre-built in less than an hour. Now, if you want something bigger, you'll need to spend a bit more time or join up with some other Vikings and work together to get something massive. You can form guilds of 2 to 4 Vikings, so talk to some people you see online and form one right now.
Do you have a guild, HMAC? Because if so, I want to be the first to join it.
Well, I don't currently have a guild because I really haven't been able to play as much as I'd like. I'd love to start one soon with some Mac family members. If you want to be on my team, reach out to me on the Discord and let's make it happen.
Oh, hey, you made it to the end of this video. You deserve a high five. Did I get you with that one? I guess not if you're still on this video, but check out this video if you want one that I know you're going to really like. Oh, you didn't like the video yet? All right, well, click down here and make sure to actually like.
You should be hitting one of these buttons and getting off of this video soon, because I'm really running out of things to talk about. Just click off into something, okay? All right, bye.